everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we are doing a Liatris seed harvest. It has been so hot here for the last week and a half, in the 90s. That is hotter than it has been all summer. And then we had many of them strung together in a row. Air conditioners have been on. We've had no rain. Everything is turning brown. The leaves are falling off the trees now, a little bit early.
And I'm wilting.
And the liatris, which some of you know I love dearly, has some of it is ready to harvest. And we are supposed to, they keep promising that we're going to get rain this evening, and I wanted to harvest some of them before it started raining because I don't want them damp when I harvest them. It's really easy to do when you have liatris. You just take the head. Now this shows you how tall it gets, so it's like up to my belt almost, and the top third at least is the flower head, which starts at the top blossoming and goes down to the bottom. And you can see this is ready. So all I do is I just pull.
Kind of like shucking corn.
Yes, and I end up with all of these seeds. Now each seed has a little feather. Yeah, it's more like a feather actually, attached to it.
That's a little white thing that's actually the seed.
Well, it's a little black, the black seed there.
Oh, the black seed.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yep. And it has a white case around it, which you'll see in here.
Oh, that's what I was seeing.
Yeah. Right. Okay. Yeah, but it's actually the little black part.
I mean, you already have maybe an eighth of a bag
full ready. Oh, at least. Yes.
And you haven't even done.
No. And then, you know, this part, because this is the part that blossoms later, this part isn't even ready yet. But I've just been going to the ones that are ready and just stripping them down. So, you know, if you have liatris and you want more of them, this is the way to get more. Because now all I do is sprinkle this around in places where I want it and I kind of stomp it into the ground. We've also been taught by the prairie tenders that you can roughen the earth where you want them to be and then sprinkle them down right before it's going to snow for the first time and let the snow be their blanket and they'll come up in the spring. Either way, they need to be cold because they are perennials. So if you don't get around to planting them this fall, you can keep them in a cold place and then plant them in the spring. It works easily.
Do you have to keep them cold? Do they require a stratification?
Yes, they are a perennial, so I'm guessing they need to go through a cold period in order to germinate the best. You know, they may do it now without that cold, but for me, I found the best way is to have them go through the cold.
Okay.
Now, I have many here.
Well, you only have a few here, maybe 100 or so, right?
Well,
and that's just in this area.
Saving them. Yes, I've been waiting for them to get ready, because then what I'll do, you know, is I'll clip it off. And then it doesn't look quite so scraggly.
Yeah, because the green is still absorbing the energy from the sun.
Correct.
Going through its what, photosynthesis or whatever.
Right, and each
feeding the roots.
Each little plant has a tiny little, I don't know if it's a bulb or a corm or what it is, under the ground. And when it comes up in the spring, it looks like grass, but if you pull it out, there's a tiny little bulb on the end of each one of these. So that's how you can tell, oh, that's not grass, that's liatris.
Yeah. Well, let me put the camera down and help you, after we get going here, harvest some more liatris seeds.
Very good.
Look at that. They're all over the ground, too.
Well, and some of this is dill, so I don't want that dill to go back in there. I'm going to have to sweep that dill up.
Oh, I want the dill to go back in there.
No, there's enough already, just from...
You can never have enough dill.
Yeah, I think you can.
Well, then you can have too many liatris.
No, no, you can't. something else I wanted to mention is that these little stalks are very tough. They're strong. They will break if you bend them enough. But if you need little markers for something to mark where you've planted something, or maybe you need something for a fall bouquet and you need it to tie on, this might be it. Now remember I said when Liatris first comes up in the spring, it looks like grass, and crabgrass, which is not good. So I wanted to show you what a little Liatris looks like so you can tell the difference. This is the Liatris. Now underneath here, there are 1, 2, 3 of them together. Each one of those would have that little bulb underneath. This is grass. So you can see this is finer, uglier, mixed in with my iris. But this is a deeper green. It has wider leaves. And this will eventually send the stalk up and we'll get the leaves off of each side of it. So it'll be very plumy. It'll be lovely. Now we have an offer for anybody that's interested.
Well, let me stand up first because my feet are hurting.
Okay. Oh, let me sit down here at my garden bench and rest myself. Ah, oh, very, very cozy. Look at how many seeds we have harvested.
That's half a bag full.
It is. And I mean, yes, some of it is fluff. Because like I said, each one has a little feather at the top, which helps catch the wind and send it off so it can plant itself elsewhere. Sometimes Liatris is called gay feather, and maybe this is why, because it does seem to have that little feather at the top. We would like to make an offer to you, our viewers, who have been so sweet and kind and supported us all this while. We would like to send you a bag of Liatris seeds that can be planted either this fall or next spring. All you need to do is send us, Wisconsin Garden, a self-addressed stamped envelope.
That's really important that you have all your information there, because right. All we're going to do is fill it up and send it back to you.
We're just going to send you this little package of Liatris seeds. And wish you the best of luck, and hopefully you'll love Liatris as much as I do.
Well, we're going to scroll the address right under this, and also, if one forgets, they can always Google the words Wisconsin and the word garden, and you'll see all of our contact information on the very first search engine page. Just look over to the right, you'll see some pictures and a bunch of other goodies that Google seems to like us.
I'm glad.
But what is today's date?
Today is September 26th.
2017.
And we're going to make this offer good until October 15, 2017. So that's about 2 weeks. So if you can, within the next 2 weeks, and if you want some seeds, please send us that self-addressed stamped envelope and we will send you package of Liatris seeds.
Yeah, and we have to also say that, you know, this is on a first come first serve basis, because I know you have thousands of viewers.
Yes.
And while I'd like to make up 1,000 bags, I don't think, you know, we'll be lucky if we get maybe 50 bags to share out there, but we'll be more than happy to do it to the first viewers that get their self addressed stamped envelopes to us.
If you've enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We'd love to hear your comments and questions, and more so, we'd love to see your envelope come to us and we can send it back to you with some Liatris seeds.
I like your little bench, by the way.
Thank you. It's very cozy, very comfy.
So I suppose you're tired from collecting, harvesting all your Liatris seeds
no,
now.
No, I'm not tired, but I'm really hot because it's still in the 80s and it's very humid and it's kind of pregnant out here. Which is good because we're waiting for rain.
Finally.
If you'd like to become part of our garden family, please subscribe at this little button. Thank you again for watching.
And happy harvesting. This is a good time of year to start harvesting all your seeds.
Yes, it is.
Connect with us on YouTube.